Welcome to a new episode from Emil Truthman Visionary Talks, three episodes with solutions, ideas, and talks about the Generation Y. The name of this talk is, The Millennials Generation Biggest Problem. This is part one. The generation with the most people having the life status messed up. The biggest problem and the biggest concern of my generation, the millennials, is not money or debt. I repeat, the biggest problem we have is our social status, our place and life situation in the world we live in, here, today, and in the present circumstances. Here are some real truth facts in which we swim to survive. We feel alone, we are single, and live with our parents. We don't work, don't study, and some of us have bad debts, school debts or consumerism debts. I will share in 100 words, my personal example in the end of this episode. The generation of present and the pensioners of the future, now we have between 25 and 40, we are all in the working era, currently we are struggling in the second economic crisis, and time is running against us. Of course we have plans, we want to be, to have, to live, to love, but the circumstances, the lack of motivation and the way we grew and lived until now, will make us the bad example generation, unless we heal ourselves. The social status is a form of continuously stress, a post-traumatic trauma, a problem that we need to solve. Just look at the desperate single men and women, who have issues finding a right person to start a family. Let's start this talk. Part 2 and 3 of this topic have the links in the description of this video. The generation with the most people having the life status messed up. The generation with the biggest number of single men and women in history. A single mom of three kids, wrote on her Facebook at the social status, from single to in a complicated relationship, to engaged and married, and divorced, now I am healed. No more relations. Another talk between two girls, why don't you leave him? With his social status he can find another girl like me next day, but for me is difficult to find someone like him, and to accept me as I am. Like I said in various episodes on my channel, we get married because of hate, men hate being single, women hate being poor. Or the two types of relationships, the rare ones, love relations, or the most common, healing relations or for both sides benefits. The social status means a person's standing or importance in relation to other people within a society. Why are millennials single? And this life fact leads to huge economic, social isolation, and more each personal self-esteem problems. Some work too much and wait for the perfect one to fall from the clouds, some are too lazy, nobody wants a lazy person near him for entire life. Another problem, I know many couples who divorced because they earn too much money, because they argue on what to spend the extra income. The girls wait for the rich, stupid, and good-looking man who is not looking at them, or never shows up. And the boys hope for a Barbie girl, businesswoman, mother, and housewife, all in one, except that this kind of girls/woman don't choose a mediocre man. And after 30 or 35 years old, men are thinking at women from Generation Z, smaller with 10 years, and women are marrying men from Generation X, bigger with 10 or 15 years, wealthy who want children. This is the ugly truth of our generation, no friends, no family, almost zero vision to change because we already have 10, 15, or 20 years of working and spending, creating comfortable habits, toxic thoughts and behaviors, and lower motivation. Not having enough love motivation to invest in a long-term relationship. Our social status means also our relation with our parents, baby boomers. Many of us depend financially and emotionally to our parents, and if we get out of the family nest, we are too fragile to survive in this competitive world called real life. Healing means the process of making or becoming healthy again. Healing this generation, my generation, means to figure it out in the next 5 to 10 years how to combine whatever we do in life, work with family life, getting married, have a life plan, a direction in life, a vision. Why to work hard, to accumulate wealth, when you are single and you will remain single, after an age things get clear, or without children whom to inherit your cultural and material legacy. The generation who prefer buying dogs, instead of taking the responsibility and the blessing of having children, even in these times with never-ending crises. I am thinking at the crises that were in the past, 1930, or other ones, kids were born also in those times, kids were born in prisons, concentration camps in the world wars, and kids were born also in times of peace. If we don't take it hard, the decision we know we must make, the change we need to make to change our lives, my and your life, things will remain the same. The social status, we are single because of fears, the fear or suffering, the fear of divorce, the fear of change, the fear of poverty, the fear of not being accepted as we are, how we are, the fear that comes from my personal problems, failed relations, disappointments, unrequired love, unshared love, jealousy, low self-esteem, personal issues and daily habits and living expectations, my goal with your vision of life, may not be the same at a certain point in life. If we are rich, we want prenuptial agreement, if we are poor, we look for someone with higher social status and more money, but honest, what are the chances? Different personality and character, one is too educated, the other is lazy to learn. We have different thoughts about life facts, personal experiences, and the flexibility to change or to adapt. The social status is seen in every aspect of life, how people work, how people smile and how people react to outside their life emotional attacks. How we use our money, how we earn our money and long-term planning. To heal us, together we will change the future, but if everyone remains isolated and alone, things are getting worse for everyone. Some are thankful, some are greedy, some are undecided. How can we heal our generation, is when we hide in our bubble world, and no one knows what a great person, friend, husband, or wife I can be. What talents, skills, looks and voice I have. I look around, and observe my generation, we are over 30 years old, observe the school colleagues and working colleagues, same age as mine, millennials. Just like in the image of this video, no car, no house, no savings, no friends, sad and stuck in mediocre job, no vision and no motivation to change. We depend on our parents' income, and we lend money to pass another month of expenses. And waiting to find the perfect person who accept their social status, and to get married with them, really? Independent woman choose powerful men. Powerful men choose involved woman. A mother for their children. The solution is love and work, anything you can find, go out in the real world. You as a man must have the words and work to be the man in the house, and you as a woman must have the vision of the man he can be near you, if he really wants you. If he doesn't love you, if she doesn't love you, why stay? It sounds ugly, but the truth is the middle line. And living in the same house with your parents, grandparents, your wife, and your kids is not easy from the social view, but the cost of living and housing prices are making life easier with many sources of income and with no long-term debt. The next episode is about poor millennials' money and future. Go out. Meet new people, pray to God to help you find the wife or husband meant for you, don't be afraid by the gift you will receive from life. What could happen? I am 36, staying with my parents, baby boomers, and sister, also a millennial, we are not married, we don't have a car, sister doesn't work, I own two properties and one long-term debt, I invest the money I save by staying with my parents, I work a mediocre job but paid well for the city I live in, I have hope for the future. Everyone has problems, these economic crises affects us all. Still the change remain and always will remain in our hands. Solve your social status, find other reasons to live, new motivation of working. If we don't heal this wound, the future looks gray, with elderly people alone in their houses and with mental issues and health problems. Check out part 2 of this video, thank you for listening.